Hi everyone, I'm Diana Lizalde and I'm a sophomore at Marion. And this poem is titled Unexpected. On October of 1999, a young Mexican couple arrived in the land of America with doubt in their mind of the trajectory they had accomplished. Not knowing that a small human being was already forming in the womb of the woman, aliens to what it felt as a whole new world, relatives had turned into monsters, helping the Green Guard and his duty to frighten. But 8 months later, a spark of hope. The joy of a firstborn child overwhelmed the hearts of the wetbacks from Mexico, naming their daughter after a princess with a vision of royal life, praying that their daughter would break through the chains of their family's history, jumping the border into what seemed to be more misery, walking down the never-ending sinuous road. But the little girl started to grow up with the realization that her family cannot erase their colorful past. They cannot erase the fear of deportation, the feeling that their daughter would become an orphan, or the racial discrimination against her family over appearances that cannot be modified. But let's not forget to mention that little boys and girls at school can be more cruel than the trained soldier, for this little girl was spat on, insulted, shoved, and told that her value was equal to a brown dog, isolating herself from those classmates who seemed superior to what she was. And even though the name Diana, which means divine, was bestowed on her, little Diana had never felt so far from heaven before. But she perceived a change in her life. And I know she made a change in her life because that little girl is me. I got tired of all the criticism and came to a realization that my life was worth more than all the gold in the world, no matter what a five-year-old white girl decides the fate of my future is. My kind parents were my two pillars of support to build my foundation and construct the building of my new life, creating day-by-day floors filled with memories and nightmares that flood my existence, windows creating a mural of laughter and music, exposing to the universe that this girl did not give up. I couldn't give up. Because I want you to know our story. The tale of immigrants who come to America not expecting to have a child, the experience of almost complete poverty to which I was born in. Because so many others, like my dear family and I, know what it feels like to not fit in. To be told that you're not good enough because of your color, that our specialty is stealing jobs and selling drugs to make ends meet, but have you gone to the fields and ranches? Have you seen the thousands of Hispanics working long hours in the sun, picking tomatoes, potatoes, and corn just so the children could have a plate of food in front of them? All I ask is for you to treat us equally. You see our faces, but not our stories. And the color of our skin shouldn't even matter, because when you're always searching to get tanner in the summer, becoming hypocrites, hating on the people who have had us since day one. Because we are here to tell our stories. And I know that our stories can crack your heart of stone.